In this video, I'm gonna show you how to key like a pro. This is the image we are working with today. It's just this girl that's kind of chilling in a hammock. And this is my normal node tree structure. If you are not familiar with my method, there is another video that I made covering my node structure. So I do a node-based structure. I start with my CSTs, and then I have four primaries, and then I have some secondaries. The tricky part, if you do it like this, is that if you want a key, it can get a bit tricky. So just a real quick recap. This is Blackmagic footage. The first CST changes it from Blackmagic to DaVinci. I always work in DaVinci wide gamut because if you have different types of cameras with different types of color spaces, this is a really good color space to work in. From the CST, I add a second CST that changes DaVinci wide gamut to Rec 709. I'm just going to turn that on. I always try and work in here. This is where DaVinci wide gamut is happening. So this is where you kind of want to work in. So I'm going to show you an issue you can run into. Let's say you want to pull a qualifier. I would not urge you to do it, but if you do need to pull a qualifier, you'll probably do it right here. And this is the problem. Although the image you are looking at right now looks fine, it looks good, it's what you are seeing after this last node. What this guy is working with is actually this. It's a very flat image. If I take a key from this, it might be okay, but it's not ideal. The key is not going to be as clean as it can be. This is what you do if you want to grab a key in this type of workflow. You're going to create something that's called an orphan node. I'm going to add a corrector. I'm going to add another CST. This footage is Blackmagic. I think it was 4.6. Yes, 4.6. Blackmagic 4.6. And now I'm going to output it into Rec 709. So to recap, here the image is flat. On this node, the image is not flat. It's actually turned into Rec 709. The thing is, we aren't going to connect this to the end here. We are actually only going to use the mask. And this is how you do it. So Blackmagic is in. Now this is Rec 709. Now you use these guys. So I'm going to do serial node, parallel, parallel, parallel. I'm just going to turn the highlighter off. And all your key masks are going to happen here. I'll label this skin. Let's see what the difference is between these two nodes. I'm going to highlight my footage again. On this node, this is the image I'm working with. On this node, that's the image I'm working with. And the key on a flat image is very tricky. The keying is going to happen here. I'm going to just use this key and I'm going to key her skin. Key her skin. I'll denoise it a bit. Maybe do it like that. And then I'm going to link this node with that node. All your qualifiers are going to happen here. When you link this, here you are working with DaVinci wide gamut, but you are pulling the key mask from when it's already converted to Rec 7 or 9. So when you make changes on here, you are actually still working in DaVinci Wide Gamut. And so if you ever need to pull qualifiers in this type of workflow, orphanodes are your best friend.